All right, guys, so I just wanted to jump on real quick and show you two things. I've had this 7-string for quite some time, and I haven't really brought it here and showed you, but it's pretty awesome. I really love this 7-string a lot. Big fan of it. Anyways, I also was able to pick up a really awesome BlackStar amp this past week. I was on Guitar Center Used, and I was able to pick up this amp right here. It's a 1 watt, so it's the BlackStar HT1RH, so it has the reverb in there. Full fucking tube amp, right? 1 watt, and it's monstrous. So I want to take you through some stuff. We're going to be in the clean channel straight up. Only pedal I'll be probably turning on in this demo will be the Archer. So clean tone, neck pickup, here's the amp. I really am in super love with this amp. Pretty tame, right? You know, nice humble beginnings for it, you know. Let's turn the EP booster on. I have the reverb set kind of low. Let's maybe put some more of that in there, right? My microphone's making a lot of noise, I don't know why. Not bad. Not why I bought this amp. Alright, let's kick it into what I like to play with. The overdrive section. So now we got a level about 12. Gain at about like 9, all right, and then the ISF is at, I guess, 2 or 3, yeah, something like that. So nice and crunchy. Check out the Archer. So we're running out of the output of the amp, straight into my isolation cab, SM57, ribbon mic, back into the jam hub running straight into the camera with the microphone mixed into it. That's the setup. This is the first amp with a emulated line out headphone jack that I thought blows away my speaker setup. Okay, so this is what it sounds like with my speaker setup. So this is the SM57 and the R40. And so I just want to show you. It doesn't sound too bad with stock Jackson pickups on a 7-string, right? Check this out. Lots of attack. And like I said, the gain isn't dimed. Now I got the gain at 12 o'clock. We'll be right back. that reverb off. This is just the Archer in a pretty boosted setting of the amp. I do like the reverb on the amp. I mean, like, I have several amps here, and no lie, I spent a lot of time back when this amp was made. I never bought it. I wanted to buy it. It was just a little too expensive for what I wanted, and I haven't had a chance to, I had not at that time had a chance to actually play it to justify the $499. I picked it up for $139 used on Guitar Center. I'm happy with it. I mean, I wish I would have bought this 4 years ago when they first came out. I probably wouldn't have bought all these other amps because this amp does it. This thing is very open and broad sounding, whereas like there's certain settings on the PV6505MH, another Lunchbox amp out there, where the signal sounds way too compressed and just too squashed and just not usable. I haven't run into that with this amp. This amp, all the way around, in all the settings of the ISF and the gain, don't suck. It doesn't suck, where some amps do, right? Some Marshalls, you put too much gain in front of them, they sound like shit. This one, I love it. So I want to show you what this amp sounds like with the headphone out. So that was my normal speaker setup, right? And this is the way I would run the amp. All my amps, I run them just like that. But now, as you can see right here in the mini cam, that just disengaged the output, put a dummy load, and now we're running in the emulated out. So I have that on channel 4 here on this thing. Let's see how... let's give it an audio test real quick. Make sure I'm not clipping, all right? See how the reverb is really big when you plug it in? And the neck pickup sounds a lot better. So if you're on a budget and you're looking for a really badass, good metal rock and decent clean tone amp, this one. Pick one of these up used for $150 on Guitar Center, and don't even think about buying anything else. This is the amp. This is it. I mean, this is the amp. This is the sound I've been looking for so long, and having something like an Archer in front of it doesn't hurt at all. It sounds really good with the Archer. Turn that off. Doesn't sound bad about it. I need to tune this thing after all those bends. Yeah, so I've had this 7-string for quite some time now, actually, and I really love this fucking guitar. Like I said, once you get used to a good 7-string neck, it's really hard to go back to playing a 6-string neck, and just, like, for me it was. I just wanted to touch briefly on this guitar. As far as the, under $300, $400, $500, 7-string range, Jackson has got it nailed. These are fucking awesome. The first one I bought was the black one I have up here on this wall that you can't see. It's like a flat satin black, you know, the cheapest one in the range. And I love that guitar, right? And then so I was like, you know what? I can do one better. I really like binding, right? Love binding on my guitars, on the necks, the headstock, reverse headstock. That's a big thing for me, is I really like a reverse headstock. They're mean as shit. And I think all guitars should have reverse headstocks. Most of my guitars that I really play a lot have reverse headstocks. The burst, you know, it's kind of a cheesy paint job, to be perfectly honest. But, I wanted something different than black because I already had the black one. I should have got the slime green one. I just backed the ISF back. Like I was saying, the emulated output on this amp, which is what I'm running right now, straight into the jam hub in channel 4, and the microphones in channel 3, and then the two microphones in my isolation cab are in channel 1 and 2. And the only thing you're hearing right now is channel 3, this microphone, and then the channel 4, which is a line out. Dude, it's fucking amazing. I mean, ever since I picked up this amp Thursday, I've played my guitar more. I've come in here, I dusted this thing off, I gave it a nice shining, and I started jamming just to hear what a 7-string sounded like on it. And next week, I'll do a video without the 7-string, but this week I just wanted to show, finally, this 7-string, because I haven't played it, and it really deserved to be played, because it's a beautiful guitar, and it plays fabulous. If you're looking for a 7-string guitar, and you don't want the cheap satin one that Jackson runs, don't be afraid for this, because this has direct mount pickups. There's no like pickup rings and all that. I think this is like a Jackson modified hip shop bridge. It's got the strings through the body, so you get all that resonance. Really a fucking awesome guitar. I mean, really a fucking awesome guitar. I really enjoy this guitar a lot. Need to get some better strings because the scale length is longer. It made the tension on my normal gauge a little bit thicker than I like to play with, so I'll definitely try to lighten the gauge up a little bit but keep the heavy on the bottom, because I do appreciate that heavy chugging bottom. So, you know, I just wanted to show you this guitar and this amp. If you're on a budget, get this 7-string, badass 7-string, get that amp, badass amp. You can walk out of the guitar store probably under $700, probably under $500 if you got them both used. I imagine you can get this guitar used probably for like $200 to $300, and that one for like $150. So probably walk out of a guitar center with these two items for $500 and below and get a crushing tone. Now, I was using the Archer in front of it. You don't have to, but you could use something like a Soul Food or even the Sweet Baby. I was using the Sweet Baby earlier today, and it sounded great through the amp. So, Archer isn't a total must-have, but it's nice to have it to kind of pick up those highs and dole out some of the lows. So, you know, I'm chilling. I hope you guys are having a good week, and I hope you enjoyed this. Come back next week, and maybe we'll play a different guitar through the same amp, because I can't wait to show you what this amp can do.